Swing, bada 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 boo, swing.
Song, sing the song. So this is a song about songs.
What are you doing?
Sing a song about songs. I don't know all the lyrics to Come Baby Come Baby.
Baby come, you gotta give me love and I gotta give me some.
You gotta give me if you're gonna get a popcorn, then you gotta give me some.
I don't think I've right? even heard that song.
Really? I like that song a lot.
Yeah.
It's a great song.
Gets you in the mood.
Is it about coming?
Yeah, I think so, because it's like, come baby, come baby, baby come, come. It's mostly about come.
Two of the comes are spelled C-U-M, but it's about a guy encouraging the girl to come first. Come baby, come baby. Like, come on baby, come baby. Baby come is C-O-M-E, come.
Oh, so like come here and then
and
come.
Come here and come. Come on, come.
So it's like a girl that's somewhere else and he wants to make her come, so she has to come to him.
To him to come.
To come.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Baby come. Come
to come.
Oh, baby come.
Baby come to come.
Yeah, I think, and then he directs his attention to a baby. Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't think babies can produce come yet.
No, maybe. it's about him wanting a baby.
Or he just doesn't know that.
Oh, he wants to make a baby with
come,
his come.
Baby, yeah.
A cum baby.
A cum baby.
All babies really are cum babies.
Pretty much.
They're all made from cum.
Especially when they first come out.
Cum produced.
Yeah.
I wonder if a baby was ever born with like some load still on it.
Oh,
like some of the jizz that wasn't used to make the baby.
Like maybe one of the, like two of the jizz sperms, two of the sperms snuck in. One of them gestated and just the other one just hung out for a while, like on the baby's stomach.
Like if you just had like, so the baby's born with a load on it already.
Yeah, a tiny load. Like it's like a pet dog, but it's just one sperm.
The guy would have to have some like really thick cum with some staying power.
Stain power?
Staying power.
Oh, staying power.
Like it's a really fucking like dense, like concentrated cum, you know. By the time the baby's born, there's just a little tiny bit of it left.
That would be like, I mean, I guess as long as the baby's healthy, be like 10 fingers, 10 toes, one load on it.
Yeah.
That's fine.
Yeah.
You could wipe
there's
the
no
load
reason
off.
For it, to be, it might be healthier than other babies because there's a lot of protein.
And there's more, like, if the baby's not finished yet, you just rub more cum on it. Can you do that? Like, if you...
Afterwards? No, I think...
As long as the cum comes out with the baby, you can probably still rub it on the baby.
Also,
right?
I think it would be hard to convince the doctor... Like, no, that was from earlier.
Is it illegal to, like... If you, like, I mean, you're probably not allowed to just come on a baby. That's
probably
rude.
No, definitely not.
Also,
it is
but that
rude.
Would be an awkward
rude.
Bill to write, though. So there's a chance that there's not a bill that says no coming on babies.
Yeah. All the senators were too embarrassed to talk about
somehow
it. I don't know.
Through.
This is like...
But what if you, like, what if you went into another room?
Okay.
You cummed into a Dixie cup.
Yeah.
And then you came in with a Q-tip and just, like, rubbed a little cum on the baby's arm.
Oh, yeah.
Would that be, like, weird?
I guess, well,
like, I mean, it's weird, but is that illegal?
what was your intentions? I bet the law lies within your intentions.
I don't want, you know, these aren't things I'm interested in.
I'm just
naturally inquisitive.
Yeah. What if you just did it to embarrass the baby?
Yeah, it's not for any perverted purpose.
Teach
it's just to, like, maybe it's a medical thing. There's probably medicinal use for putting cum on like wounds or something like that.
It's a weird medicine man trick, yeah.
Yeah.
Is it gay if, let's say, like, you know, the three of us are best friends.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And let's say, like, you're the only one with a girlfriend now.
Me, Randy.
Yeah, Randy.
Oh, we didn't introduce ourselves.
Oh, hi, everyone. Welcome to the Bone Zone. My name is Brendan Walsh, and across from me is Randy Liedtke.
Randy Liedtke, hello.
And next to him is Davey Johnson.
How's it going, Zone Troopers?
And working the ones and twos is Brian Redban. Doing the twos and ones.
Yeah, doing all the maths for us.
So welcome to another installment of the Bone Zone.
Yeah, hope you're ready to be blown away.
We've already started blowing you away, so
hope you're prepared for a second round.
Yeah, you're gonna just keep getting blown away.
What were you saying? I'm the one with a girlfriend.
So, like, let's say, okay. So you and Chelsea want to have a baby, right? But, like, the best baby would be if the three of us mixed our cums together.
Oh, yeah, in a blender. You got a juicer.
Well, you wouldn't want to put it in a juicer because then it would probably knock some of the sperms out of our cums.
Probably.
But if we just, like, if we each, and, like, one by one.
In the filter.
Yeah.
You end up with just cum in the cup.
yeah, and all the sperms.
The filter is just sperm.
Yeah. There's sperms in our cum.
Yeah, you got to throw that in your compost pile. So if we just, no, just like in a Dixie cup. And, like, we don't do it at the same time, so it's not gay.
Yeah, we have a
schedule.
So
the three of us, we just, like, I guess since it's, well, I don't know, since it's your girlfriend, would you want to come into the cup first or last? I guess it doesn't matter.
Oh, but then how's she going to insert it? Because if you have to use like a baster or something, then it's going to draw mostly from
the
bottom.
Maybe I could, like, we would mix it. So we all go.
What if I just gargle it in my mouth and then spit it inside of her?
Ooh.
You know?
But what about, I mean, also, I want to have sex with her, so maybe I could like put a straw in my dick and drink the cum and then have sex with her.
Uh-huh.
Use your dick as a straw and drink from your balls.
Oh.
Well, you could just, dick of this is honestly the straw of the balls.
Or you could just, like, you know, because you probably have to do it pretty quickly, so
we
go in one after another.
Okay.
We each come into the cup.
Yeah. All right.
You mix it up with a popsicle stick.
Yeah.
And then just maybe in the other room, Chelsea's in there standing on her head with no clothes on, and you just, like, pour it in her.
Okay.
And then... Then we would have like a super baby.
Yeah, and then
like three of our babies.
We could go to a carnival and put her on one of those Gravitron things and just have her spread her legs. That way it gets way in there.
Yeah. It's still mixing after it's been mixed.
Yeah.
That way.
We should do that.
And so then, and then it would be like, whose baby is she going to have? Or is she going to have like a super Bone Zone baby?
Yeah.
That is a good question. Is just one of our sperms going to make it in there? Or will they have been mixed so much that they've kind of melded together?
What if she has triplets and it's one of each of us?
That would be a dream.
That would be.
And then.
There's three different hairstyles come out of her.
Yeah. And then those three kids can go on to... make a podcast and keep our name alive.
We gotta keep the podcast name alive.
It would be hard at first because most babies are born kind of bald, so
to see which one Davey's baby would be.
We'd have to wait. Well, I guess the one with the mustache.
Yeah, the mustache. Guys, we should get babies that look like us to go on something with us. Do you think we could
rent babies that look like us?
Rent babies that look like us. Like, let's go to a dog park or something, but we'll have those little what do they call them? Those little blankety straps that people use with where their babies are kind of basically tied up to their chest.
Oh, a baby Bjorn.
A baby Bjorn, yeah. We have three of those, but they each are babies with our exact same facial types.
Yeah.
Facial hair types.
Really interesting, yeah.
Yeah. And then...
if anybody has babies out there...
That look like us.
Or just, you know, like a redheaded baby, brown-haired baby, and like, yeah, it's the one with slightly less hair, and then we could put fake beards on the redhead and the brown hair, and then a mustache on the slightly balder baby.
That would be a killer Bone Zone poster.
That would be.
Bone Zone babies.
Yeah. Yeah. The Bone Zone babies.
And it could be a spinoff, like Muppet Babies.
Yeah, that was
like a huge hit.
Yeah. We'll rent a pair of stilts and like create some sort of giant legs that you can see that are the adult that comes in to talk to him, because it's only the legs that you see in the Muppet Babies, right?
I don't know. Oh, right, yeah, the adults, you never see their...
Yeah, you only see their giant gams. Mm. Oh, man.
Should we mention that we're sitting on the floor?
Oh, yeah, budget cuts. We ran out of chairs here at the Death Squad Studios.
A lot of chairs. This whole time we've been sitting on the floor, crisscross applesauce style.
Yeah.
What's crisscross applesauce style? What
the hands up, ears open. All right, hands down, ears closed.
What? What?
What is that?
But then how do we hear the next command?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Guys, you still there?
Hello?
Guys, you there?
Yeah. Hands up, mouth shut. Davey. Maybe that's how it went.
Kind of like this style.
Yeah, let's look under the table. But you can't get the mics that low.
I can. Oh, you can't. You can kind of. What's up, guys? Whoa, hey, yeah, I can see you. Yeah.
I think I just shocked myself somehow. Is that because we're on the ground?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
All the electricity.
Oh, shit. I just got shocked.
Yeah, okay. Well, let's not touch any wires.
Yeah, be careful.
So, we should make...
I think I found Little Esther.
Oh, Little Esther's trapped in some wires.
She lives down there in a nest. little Nester.
Esther's nest.
I was just thinking about that. I remember when we called that guy who tried to fight me over a parking spot.
Oh, yeah.
And then the fake name you came up with was Nester.
Oh, yeah. Because it was a Coke guy. I think I used to know a Coke guy in Philadelphia named Nester.
Named Nester?
Oh, really?
Well, that's like a Puerto Rican name.
I never heard that, and just off the top of the head, that was such a funny name. Yo, what's up, dog? This is Nester.
Nester Rodriguez.
That sounds like a legitimate cocaine guy name.
Yeah,
not that all Puerto Ricans are coke dealers, but all coke dealers are Puerto Rican.
Yeah, and all Nesters.
Yeah, it's like
are
a square and a rectangle.
Yeah. Yeah, now we're back in the game.
Yeah.
Hands up, ears open. Wait, what?
What's that from? Is that like an elementary school? Like,
I think it's hands up, mouth shut, or something.
What's that from? Is that like?
It's just like a command, you know, like everyone needs to be quiet, so the teacher would raise their hands, and then everyone else would have to raise them. Because we're sitting like children right now.
Sounds like we're at an assembly, seeing who's going to be the honorary student. Of the
elementary
month.
School assemblies, where you had to sit on the ground.
Yeah,
that's the worst.
Yeah, my back would get so tired.
Yeah, I would have to bring one of those big heavy lifting back support things,
mm-hmm. or one of those like folding lawn chairs that people bring to concerts, outdoor concerts.
Yeah. You guys remember when you used to have blankets that you had to bring for nap time, and it was just like a little rug that you used to sleep on?
I remember going to like a daycare place that I'd never been. I never took naps at a daycare, I don't think so.
Yeah.
But this one, they had like an allotted time for naps, and I was new, and I was like, what? And everyone was getting in these weird, they looked like sleds, like these little plastic cots that just laid on the ground.
Uh-huh. Oh, man.
And I was like, no. Like, I've never... even to right now, I have a really hard time taking a nap during the day, even if I'm really tired.
Did you ever try going to just one of your local daycares and try to take a nap there with all the kids?
like recently?
Yes. No. Bring your own blanket?
Only when I want to embarrass babies.
Yeah.
I found out, we did that in kindergarten. We had a nap time, and I found out, like, I stayed awake during one of them, and the teacher was shuffling in all these old men and women that she charged to come in and watch us nap. They're just people who wanted to watch us nap.
That's weird.
Yeah.
So it was like a little bit of
some sort of like trying to steal your youth sort of thing. Like,
it's like getting old people, getting them puppies.
Yeah. Or you know, like how cats are supposedly will suck the soul out of your body when you're sleeping.
Yeah.
I think it was that.
But nobody was hurt though. They just let old people watch little kids nap. Do you think there's legislature about that?
I don't know.
There's probably one about cumming on babies.
There's
but what
gotta
about
be.
Old
and
guys
it's
watching
it's referred
kids
to as
nap.
The cum law.
They have a webcam site that's just kids sleeping.
Is there really?
And old men just sit there and watch. No. Do you think that would be illegal?
I don't know. Would it?
Do you think it's illegal if like you're in a room full of napping preschoolers and they're all sound asleep?
Oh, yeah.
And then, but you just sit in a chair in the corner and rub one out and not looking at the kids,
not
though. Like you're looking at your iPad.
Yeah.
Yeah,
you got some sweet, sweet adult-sized porn on your iPad.
If you build like
that's probably illegal.
If you build like a wall of blocks between you and the kids, like if you go into their play area and you build like a
if you go into the restroom,
like you build a fort,
you build a little jerk off fort.
Yeah, you go into the restroom in the kindergarten area and you lock yourself in there.
But you have to be careful because if you start jerking off and you knock over your fort, then it is illegal.
Well, if it wakes up the kids and they see you.
Yeah, then that is, each time a baby wakes up, that's another count of it.
Oh my
God. It's illegal to publicly urinate, but it's even more illegal to do that in front of children. Like that's considered a sex offense. So I'm sure that there's pretty strict. I mean, even accidentally, like if some kids like walk by or something with their parents, then your wiener's out.
There are a lot of laws like that that are like fucked up. Not that, yeah, like nobody you shouldn't be showing your dick to any kids.
You shouldn't show it intentionally, definitely
intentionally,
not.
But like if you, because I think even if, because I thought of this the other day, there's a school that I walk past on my way home from a bar I go to.
Yeah.
And a lot of times I'll have to pee, like I forget to pee when I leave the bar. And there are a bunch of bushes out front of this school. And this is all like at night. The school's closed. So, and there's a good hiding spot to go take a leak on my way home. And I'm curious as to like if a cop saw me taking a leak next to that school at 11:30 at night. I think that's still...
Yeah, you'll get in trouble. You'll be a predator.
That's you see, no, that kind of shit is fucked up.
There are people that have stories like that, just that they're peeing in public and now they're a sex offender.
That was in that movie Horrible Bosses. I think that Charlie Day's character was a registered sex offender because he had urinated at night in a
schoolyard or something, or in a playground.
Or having sex at a park also, I think, is the same.
I bet if you have a big dick, you know, you'll get in more trouble, too.
Yeah, the bigger the dick, the more trouble you get.
Because they're like, look at this guy with his big fucking dick out by the playground. He's like, no, I'm just peeing, and I happen to be awesome and have a rad dick.
Meanwhile, your friend gets off in like 2 days, and you're like, fuck you, small-dicked bastard.
That's a good, for girls, if that's the way the law works like that, look on sex offenders' websites for guys who peed next to schools. And whoever got the biggest sentence has the biggest dick. So
you a year and inch, dog.
Oh, that would be the worst.
Year and inch.
Yeah.
That's the rule.
Well, there was a news story today where, you remember, I guess it was like a year ago, or maybe it was this year, some mob guy was found in Santa Monica.
Oh, yeah, he's Boston mob guy that like that that Scorsese movie was based off of, The Departed.
Oh, is that who it was?
Well, I mean, it's based off a foreign film, but also the American remake, they tried to channel this guy from Boston into that character. But yeah, they caught him. He's been
lam for, you know, whatever, decades.
Yeah.
So I had the news on and was peripherally paying attention to it, but his wife, they said, like, his wife is going on trial, or she got found guilty for, like, helping hide him for the last...
Oh, really?
20 years, but it's like, come on, anybody would do that. Like, it's her husband.
Yeah.
Like, how could any jury convict them where it's like, well, like, if your husband was hiding out, you'd fucking...
Yeah.
You'd help.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's weird.
I don't think
that's
not right. This 60-year-old
lady. Do you think the lawyer,
lady,
when he was doing his debriefing thing for the jury, he was like, what about the law of love?
Probably.
He was like, think with your heart.
She took an oath till death do us part.
Yeah. She honored that oath.
There was a mob guy. I grew up in a small town in Oregon, and there was, everyone just knew. There was this guy named John the Barber, and he had a barber shop that wasn't open, and everyone knew he was associated with the mob somehow. And it was kind of this thing. It's like, yeah, right. But then it was like, but don't fucking talk about him in public, because he's got people, you know, he's got ears out there.
Wow. Yeah.
And he always had these like Jaguar cars parked in front of his barber shop.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
Like, he always had like three or four cars.
They were actually cars driven by Jaguars.
Yeah.
The most expensive type of car.
Well, it's the gas pedals are very specialized. If you have a Jaguar,
they're shaped like
car.
Paws.
Yeah, they're very, very specific. Yeah.
They have little holes for the claws to go into.
And, but it was just like, don't talk about him. He had a bodyguard. But it was like, I grew up in a town with like 17,000 people.
So what is his mob all about? Like, was he hiding out?
Like a witness protection thing?
Yeah.
I think that it was just kind of known that he was in the mob. I never looked into it as to who he was, but he did end up, and he had like this really big house right on the outside of town with like lots of cars. And he did, I think by the time I was a senior in high school, he was arrested for tax evasion, which is a total mob
thing. That's something mob people do.
Yeah, and so it was like, well, everyone knows this guy's in the mob, but there's nothing to take him down, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But that's like in a small town in Oregon. John,
well, that's
the
like, who's he shaking down? How's he making mob money there? Was there stuff being filtered from bigger cities to him?
Yeah, I wonder, man. Or he was just like, all right, I'm done. Or like, he's calling the shots or something somewhere else. Or
What happens if you ever tried to Google John the Barber?
No, I haven't. But I know he was arrested.
Is that his actual mob name, or is that the name that people gave him just because he, like, do you think he started the barbershop because he was called John the Barber?
Oh, his last name is the Barber.
He would like, oh, the Barber.
The Barber, John the Barber.
The Barber, okay.
Oh, that was his last name? The Barber?
John the Barber. John the Barber.
I auditioned with this guy for a commercial one time. He was he's an Armenian gentleman. You see him in a lot of movies. He always plays Russians and stuff like that.
Did you say gentleman afterwards to make it sound like you aren't racist?
No. I'm just
he's an Armenian
saying that he was Armenian.
Gentleman.
And when we go into audition, I just knew his name was like Arthur or something like that. We go in, and he has to say his name to the camera, and he goes, Arthur de Armenian. And I was like, oh, that's really funny. He calls himself Arthur the Armenian, but his last name was Darkmenian. But, like, my racist mind was just like, oh, that's like Cedric the Entertainer. This guy's, like, handle is the Armenian.
The Entertainer.
Yeah. That's a ballsy thing to do. I saw some commercial with him in it. Somebody was there. I don't know. I saw Cedric the Entertainer somehow on TV. I was like, that's, you know.
Was he named after that song? The Entertainer?
Informer by Snow?
Cedric's last name is...
I am the Entertainer.
You guys...
No, the Scott Joplin... Is that Scott Joplin?
He was like... Oh, no, I think it was Scott Joplin. Maple House Rag.
Yeah, Maple
or something.
Scott Joplin.
Maple Syrup Rag.
Maple Leaf Rag.
He did more than that, though.
I think he did do something called The Entertainer. Did you ever hear the American Life, This American Life episode where they talk to... Cedric's brother, Larry the Entertainer. He's
a carpenter.
He's a cable guy, actually. He's really a cable guy. He's actually a cable guy.
But Larry the Entertainer. What is it?
Larry the Entertainer. He's actually a cable guy.
Now, would that be like, can we just start calling ourselves like Brendan the Entertainer, Randy the Entertainer, and Davey the Entertainer?
Well,
I would go by Randy the Entertainment.
That's a good one.
Because I am the Entertainment.
I'd like to change my name.
Davey the Entertained.
Would you shut the fuck up over there?
Yeah, some kind of fucking shit's going down.
What's going down? Oh, God! I thought for real I was going to get some shit in the face. I mean, I did get some shit in the face, but it's like silly string.
Yeah. More like dumb string.
I'm finding a lot of cool shit here.
That's probably not good. That stuff is very chemically. Are you okay, Davey?
Oh, my eyes are stinging. It's kind of stinging. Oh. Wait, it looks like bubblegum now. Should I eat it? I should eat it, right? I should eat it?
Yeah, you should eat it.
I think you should.
Oh, Red Band just ruined his studio.
He's rude as hell.
Yeah,
I was trying to talk about
place.
Coming on a baby, and you're just going to take it lightly and spray silly string on it like we're not professionals. God. This stuff is very flammable, so be careful. Have you seen those America's Funniest Home Videos clips of... Silly string and birthday cakes, and just like families dying.
Yeah,
silly strings and birthday cakes. That's a good name for like an album. Good comedy album name.
Yeah. Oh man. You guys.
God, that stuff smells.
It does. It's the acidy chemicals that are in it.
The outside of those cans is legal, but the stuff that's on the inside isn't because it's not exposed to the atmosphere. So you can put whatever you want in a silly string can. That's how a lot of people smuggle cocaine because it's actually legal.
What?
Yeah. Anything that's in a compressed, closed can, it doesn't have to meet any type of standards.
Huh.
What?
So a lot of times shampoo is actually like very deadly.
Very addictive.
I like to chew on the silly string, like collect it all and make it into a piece of gum and then chew on it.
Oh, really? Like a huge piece.
Like Davey said 5 seconds ago?
Did he really say that?
Yeah.
Are you serious?
Said something about chewing gum.
Well, it was like 30 seconds ago.
Wow.
What about silly string?
We came up with a good idea, actually.
I was thinking, like, what if you had a silly string thing implanted in your dick hole? And then you could just, like, party people.
Yeah.
Just, like, party them with string.
That'd be a major operation.
Yeah. Majorly awesome.
Yeah, but
party man
when the can runs out, that's in your abdomen.
Well, you have a place.
Like a
that,
zipper?
Well, you have, like, an extra place that you install it. It's inside of you, though. You have to have an operation.
You'd have a nut zipper.
It runs out.
You'd have a nut zipper, like the squirrel nut zippers.
Brendan loves that band.
That's my favorite band.
Randy and I came up
with... Zoot Suit Riot! Oh, yeah!
That's not them.
Oh, that's my favorite
Don't
band.
Don't forget to clean your Zoot Suits.
What's Zoot Suit Riot? Was that Brian Sweater Orchestra?
That was the...
No! It's a Squirrel Nut Zippers.
No, Squirrel Nut Zippers, their one hit wonder was called Hell.
Oh, right.
And the afterlife. You could be headed for this year. And that song wasn't swing. It was like old school, like jazz, like 20s, 30s, 40s jazz. And then the rest of their songs are actually really good. And Andrew Bird was actually in Squirrel Nut Zippers.
Oh, I didn't know that.
For one or two albums.
He's not the Cherry Poppin' guy.
That's who sings the Zoot Suit Riot. Is the Cherry the Cherry Pop John Popper, the John Chopper, the John Chopper Blues Traveler Daddies.
The Jalapeno Poppin' Daddies. Yeah. Randy and I had an idea that I think would make us billionaires. That's kind of an offshoot of Silly String, called Silly Spaghetti.
It's called Silly Spaghetti, and it's spaghetti in a can.
Yeah, you can.
And you shoot it onto your plate.
Ready made.
It's perfect idea.
And the bottom of it, of the can, screws off, and you got some marinara sauce in there.
Oh, marinara.
Marinara.
Got marinara in the bottom. And the actual...
Maybe a meatball.
The act of...
Meatball or two.
Oh, shit. The meatball, once the can's empty, the meatball just drops.
You know how,
bottom.
Like, spray paint has that ball that makes it...
Oh, yeah.
You just make that be a meatball.
That's the meatball.
And you spray your spaghetti on the plate and then take the bottom off, drop the meatball and sauce in there.
And the act of spraying it heats up the can so much that the sauce is nice and hot.
Yeah. You got some hot sauce here.
But also, one downside is the can is extremely vulnerable to highs and lows temperatures. Like, it's very dangerous. So you need to keep it in a dark place and in a very specific temperature. Otherwise, it can hurt you.
Always between 69 and 74 degrees.
That'd be hard to maintain.
It's tough. You know, when you're coming up with a new idea, it's tough to make it perfect.
Sometimes you have to, you have to take a risk.
Also, it was expensive. It was an expensive venture to make it that vulnerable to heat and cold temperatures. That was our idea. Yeah. We had to fucking bring a guy in from a different country who knew how to do that.
He's like, it'd be so easy to make this not vulnerable. And we're like, no.
Yeah.
All right.
Did we lose?
We just lost our headphones.
Lost audio.
Lost everything.
We lost everything.
Good thing.
Audio's lost.
Dude, do you have your...
That cable? Are we coming back? Back.
Are we now it is.
Coming back.
You stood up.
You standing up to me, dude?
I had to stand up to save the podcast.
Oh, maybe we should all stand up for a second. Stretch our legs.
I'm going to stay down here for a second.
I sweat more when I'm sitting on the ground.
I think it's warmer down here.
Yeah.
I think so.
Well, heat lowers.
No, it doesn't.
The opposite. Heat rises to the bottom.
It rises to the occasion.
Yeah. Oh, there we go. Good view of our torsos.
It's
kind of
nice.
Just standing?
Yeah.
Should we pull our pants up as high as they go?
Oh, yeah. Let's try it.
Oh, man.
The old Ron Lynch gag.
I got a classic case of the sweatiest balls in the world. Classic.
I wonder if
you're such a son of a gun. Mr. Red Band, you are on probation with me.
Oh, man.
This is the same outfit I was wearing when we got our picture taken at that Chinese.
Oh, really?
Yeah, yeah. Because I had my shorts pulled up real high there, too.
Brian, you're the world's worst partier.
You just target one person and you spray him.
Oh, man. Doing this really makes me realize how big my belly is and why my pants stay below
it. We look like a Rotary Club from the 70s. Like some sort of Freemason.
The hell's a Rotary Club anyway?
You know what, like, people in their 40s to 70s go to in order to not kill themselves in a boring town.
It's people who refuse to use the new style of telephone, isn't it?
Yeah.
Remember how hard it was to, like, dial fast, like your girlfriend hangs up with you, and you're like, God damn it, I have to call her back now.
I never had a girlfriend when I was that young. Yeah.
Girls don't like you when you're 3.
No, I think the last time I used a... yeah. I always had the worst luck with ladies when I was a toddler.
Yeah.
You couldn't even come, that's why.
Yeah.
I was cum free. Isn't that a type of gum? Yeah. Cum free. You want to see my bottom in these pants?
Oh, yeah.
Let's see. Turn around and see our bottoms.
Oh, dude, Randy's got the sweetest ass in that.
That's so sexy.
Looks like the Dockers ad from 1988.
You got mom shorts on.
Oh, dude, these are sweet cargo shorts.
Yeah, why are you guys, none of you guys are wearing jeans?
No, when they're pulled up that high. I literally have chosen sides.
They're all on one side?
One ball, one ball, one ball, one ball, yeah. One ball, one ball.
Huge ball.
I was in Denver this last week, Wednesday through Sunday. Met some of our scary fans.
How were they? How are the old boneheads doing?
List them by name so that they know who's scary.
Oh, I don't even want to send any shout outs. They scare me so much.
Were they all from Denver area, or did some people drive? Or
I didn't really get everybody's full story. Actually, everybody was very nice. There was that Gonzo Green guy. He was way nice less guy. Scary than I thought he would be. What? Well, don't you think when people tweet at you 900 times, you think they might be a little imbalanced? But he was fine. I was like, wait, you're that guy? Oh, you're less scary than I thought you'd be. He was
Did you
all
say
normal.
That to him?
Yeah.
Did his girlfriend come out with him?
Yeah, his girlfriend was there. She smacked her boobs on the phone, right?
Yeah,
maybe
yeah,
it was
yeah.
a different guy.
No, while you were calling someone?
One time
she smacked her boobs on your phone?
The whole time. I couldn't get her attention. She just was on a payphone smacking her boobs against it.
When you said, hey, you're way less scary than I thought you'd be, did he look at his girlfriend and be like...
I told
like,
you!
Like, no, like, give her a signal. Like, now's our chance.
Yeah. Follow him home.
Yeah.
It's working. No, everybody was nice. All the shows were fun. And then...
How's Bob Saget?
I wasn't working with Bob Saget. I was confused. There's two clubs there. He was at one.
Oh,
I was at the other.
Yeah. How was the
but their calendar's weird. Like when I looked at their calendar, it looked like we were at the same place.
Did you headline all the shows?
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, they were fun shows.
How was the weather there? Like we heard reports here that there were like badass tornadoes going on in the area.
Yeah, there was. I didn't see any tornadoes. The first night I was there, I did a show at the... Comedy Works, where actually it was overall was a fun show.
Yeah.
But the last words I said on stage where I started telling a story, and there were these drunk people there. Like there was like some office party of horrible shitheads. And like four of them were really drunk, or at least they were being disruptive. So I had to like tell them to shut up a few times. Like there was just this girl who was just drunk and would just go, "Wee!" Fucking real long, and I was like, you gotta fucking stop doing that, because like I was running late. I was like, my plane was late, and I missed my first flight because we were doing the Bone Zone the night before. I got too excited and up late packing. But either way, so then there were like these drunken assholes who were just kind of being a little annoying.
That sucks.
And having like just full-on conversation. I was like, you gotta shut up or whatever, and everybody else was having fun.
That's the worst.
And then at the end of the show, but it wasn't like so bad. You know, it was annoying, but it wasn't like completely derailing the show. Yeah. So at the very end, you know, I told a joke. I already did my time. And then I was like, there's, you know, this one story I haven't told in a while. And I was like, oh, I should start telling that again because I didn't, you know, do it for very long. And I was like, well, I was like, do you guys want to end the show or do you want to hear another story? And everybody's like, yeah, they were all like, you know, everybody's having fun. And I started telling the story, and like after the first two sentences, the, you know, stupid bitch and dumb guy started like having a conversation, and I just was like, yeah, you know what, fuck this, thanks a lot, good night, and just left. And it was like very abrupt, but I wasn't, it came off way more dramatic than it was, because everyone at the club was like, oh my god, I'm so sorry.
Like the people that worked there and stuff?
Yeah. They were apologizing, which they should have like kicked.
That's a club's job is to
well, you know, I get where they're coming from, but it's annoying. It's like when you have a group of 40 people that just spent like, you know, probably over $1,000 at the club altogether. You can't, I don't know, it's just going to, it's a tough place to be in. I'm not defending the club or those idiots, but idiots, I mean, the office party.
I would feel like the club would be mad at me for doing that.
Like that's if I how
was like, I was like, fuck you, I'm leaving.
Well, I did my time. You know,
no,
I'd already
I
done like 50 minutes and I was just going to like tell this other story because I liked most of the crowd. But then when these people started talking again, it was just like, well, this is just going to turn this 8-minute story into a 20 minutes of me fucking arguing with these people. And it's going to just derail the whole story. It's going to end really softly. And I'll be like, fuck, why did I do that?
Yeah.
So that was, but it was kind of, it is kind of liberating to just like, just be like, ah, fuck it, later, and just leave. What do you got down there, Ran?
An itch. I got an itch.
You really itching your balls?
That's my leg.
Yeah.
Ah, fuck, I'm stepping in silly string. Dude, this shit's slippery as fuck.
Yeah.
It's not funny. It's not fun. It's not funny. It's they not
call
fun.
It used to be called slippery string.
And then, so like, here's the, this is another, that wasn't really like a story. It was just kind of a story. But then Saturday night, I did a show, and then there were like some cool guys after the show were like, hey, that was really funny, and they all looked like, you know, all rock and rolled out. And I was like, oh, thanks, yeah, I'm glad you're here.
They were at the show?
Yeah, they were just like these rock and roll dudes. And they were like, hey, we're in town, we're playing a show tomorrow. You know, we're with a band. There was like some band members and some crew guys or roadies or whatever, and they're like, if you want to come to our show tomorrow, you know, we'll put you on the list or whatever. And I was oh yeah, well, I have a show, but I'll come after mine. Where are you guys playing? And he's like, the Pepsi Center. And I was like, that sounds like a big place. What's your band? And they're in a band called Seether, which sounded familiar, but I'm not like familiar with their music.
Yeah.
And I went to the place, to the Pepsi Center. It's huge, you know, it's where like the basketball team plays and shit. And the headlining band was Nickelback. Yeah, it's funny. I don't know. Can you find a Nickelback song? Like, what was their number one hit? Because
I'm trying to think. The only thing they had like that one hit when they first came out that you would probably recognize. And they also have like a really aggressively weird sex song that's like, I like your pants around your knees or something like that. And it's all about like being gross and having dirty sex.
Those guys, you know, I didn't watch much of the show. I got there when Nickelback was on stage. Uh-huh. But I got to tell you, you know, like I'm not familiar, you know, I'm probably familiar with a couple of their hits, but I couldn't, like, I have Creed songs. I just think of Creed songs when I think of them because I think they're probably similar. I've heard this. This is Nickelback?
That's what they look like? That looks like, who's that comic actor that was in Idiocracy?
Yeah, Dax Shepard.
Yeah.
He could do a killer Nickelback.
He could do a Nickelback impression.
I had a joke.
The song's not that bad.
It's not bad, but it's one of the songs they play on the radio like nonstop. The
photograph.
I'm so you know, I don't know anything about music, but every time I hear the term Nickelback, I picture Guar. I pictured that they tried to do like a Guar act where they were wearing where Nickelback just sounds like somebody wearing like some sort of flesh mask or something.
Yeah.
And just singing
Slipknot.
Nonsense. Slipknot.
Maybe you're Slipknot. Confused with Slipknot.
Oh, Nickelback and Slipknot. I confuse the two.
They're all kind of, you can put everybody in the same box there.
Yeah.
And Seether, you know, they were really cool guys. I wound up,
there's
going to
be some fucking juggalos that are like, Nickelback is not the same as Slipknot.
Do juggalos go back and forth between Slipknot and
I think juggalos are exclusive Insane Clown Posse.
Insane Clown Posse.
No, I thought Slipknot too, aren't they? Or is that Insane? Oh, man, I'm way off.
Maybe Insane Clown Posse is like, Slipknot's juggalos.
We're so uninformed.
Listen to us. Well, but my point
now
is,
we're
and this
fun
is like,
informed.
People, you know, like, you hear of Nickelback as a punchline, generally. Yeah. Like, you know, I'm like, oh, I don't know their music, but I know everybody uses them as an example of a shitty band.
I had an early on joke about Nickelback.
Everybody does.
Yeah. Nobody really knows.
Or, I mean, I never did, but it's like, that's how I'm familiar with them. It's like, people are like, oh, yeah, fucking Nickelback, and everybody just laughs. All you have to do is say the word Nickelback, but it was a sold out concert at a giant arena. There were 20,000 people there, and they were on like a stage flying around above the crowd and pyrotechnics and drum solos, and everybody was having a good time. I just went backstage and got drunk with Seether.
Do you think there was a significant amount of people that thought they were there to see Nickel Creek, that kind of indie band? Kind
I
of
think
Muppety.
They all knew what they were in store for. It was a power packed lineup. It was Seether.
And I have a question about Seether, by the way. Yeah. Is it spelled like they're seething, like they're seethers, like they just seethe a lot?
I think S-E-E-T-H-E-R.
How else would you spell it?
Seething.
And I don't know, you know, unfortunately, no offense to those guys, but I might be familiar with a song if I heard it. But when I think of them, all I think of is that Veruca Salt. Yeah, Veruca Salt song.
I don't know that.
Can't fight the Seether.
Oh, I thought you meant
can't
the
fight
I
the Seether.
I want it now. I thought the Veruca Salt song, the one she actually sings
from
Willy Wonka.
No, it's a band. But I don't know, man. Nickelback has a very, I guess they're popular, but I thought that they were.
They fizzled by now.
Yeah, they fizzled. Like, it was just like, oh, here's an example, like Creed. But I guess Creed still does shit. And this tour was like, it was Nickelback, that band Bush. You remember them from the 90s?
Yeah.
And this arena.
Well, I heard that Bush and Nickelback were touring together. So was Bush at that show too?
Yeah, but I didn't see
that guy's very popular still. Gavin Rosdell.
Is he really?
Well, he's a popular celebrity figure. Yeah. Like,
because he's married to the No Doubt lady.
Yeah. He used to be.
Okay.
Oh. Here's Seether's biggest video. See if we've heard this song before.
That's a good looking video. See? Scarecrow.
I looked them up on Wikipedia, and they have like a bunch of awards and gold and platinum albums. I love the way you
I predict it's a matter of time before these guys have the closing song to a Spider-Man movie.
Oh, you know what? They do already. There was, on their Wikipedia page, they had a song. They had like two songs in some big popular movie from years ago.
Jeez.
They were a nice guy. I recognize that guy, the singer. I didn't see them play. I got there because my show started at 7. Their show started at 7. And I didn't get there till like 9 something. And
that's cool, man. That's really cool.
Saw Nickelback and then partied backstage with Seether. And then we all got yelled at by like the local crew. Because I guess they, after the show, they invite, like, I guess they have their road crew go out and invite pretty girls backstage for like a party. And they have like this little party room in whatever venue they're at. But they only have that until midnight. And I guess it's a hard out because the guys, we were in the bathroom smoking cigarettes and throwing wet paper towels at girls trying to pee in the stall. We just thought that was so funny. Like, like bombarding them. We're like, what the fuck? And then these like two dudes, local dudes, are like, hey, what are you fucking doing? Get out. Come on, time to get out. I'm like, what? I'm with this band. They're famous guys. They were not having it. They're just like, everybody's got to leave at midnight.
Yeah. Sex by midnight. That should be.
Well, then we went to the, like, yeah, they had all these tour buses. It's really, like, this is a whole fucking business out
people
there.
People pay to see music, and like, I mean, even at the lowest level, you can get 20 people to see a shitty band, you know?
That's true.
How many stand-up shows have you done where there was, like, 5 people there? A lot.
No, I mean, yeah, not a lot. I don't know. I don't have, like, a lot of, like, memories of just only, like, a few people. Yeah. There's been times, like, I remember one time in Austin, there were 2 people at a show, and I just, like, learned their names and shot the breeze with them.
Yeah.
Well, you can't perform.
No.
What are you going to do?
The thing about music is, like, even if you're kind of half paying attention, it's still an event, but for comedy, you just have to zip it and be there, you know?
Well, those guys make a lot more money than we do, because there was, like, I don't know, tickets for that had to be, like, most expensive ones had to be, like, $100.
Yeah.
Gross.
This shirt's not very flattering on me. Are we just showing my fat belly?
Are we allowed to announce our deal with the Warped Tour?
Oh, is that, did that deal go through? I've been out of town, so I haven't talked to our managers.
Yeah. They called up. They emailed.
I don't know what the deal.
On Sunday.
I thought it was just that they messed up our order, so they're giving us our tickets for free.
Yeah.
Oh well, no, but they're doing a podcast tent.
Mm-hmm.
Podcast tent.
There's a pod tent.
Wow.
There's a pod tent at the Warped Tour. They need people to interview the bands and also provide crazy, fun banter.
Yeah, and there's going to be a bunch of live podcasts. And Aaron is headlining.
Yeah.
We have a slot.
Yeah.
Wow, I hadn't heard.
Maren's podcast is headlining for Beck, right? Is Beck's going on Warped Tour? That's really weird to me.
I doubt it. I don't think he is.
No doubt. Not I doubt. It's no doubt.
It's I doubt it.
I doubt it.
Yeah. Nickelback.
What is... how many? Because isn't Warped Tour like a whole bunch of cities?
Yeah.
Just like the bigger ones?
Look, you can see my dick.
Hey, Brendan, cool dick.
Thanks, bro.
You're welcome.
Yeah, pretty sweet dick, dude.
We should do that one day. Just like really like, we'll all go home, trim up our dicks, like, you know, get our hair done.
Yeah, I got to get my hair done.
And then like just have take a picture out of our dicks together.
Together? Like real close together?
Well, like not touching. But, like, that'd, you know, just, like, 3 though. In a row, like...
Like, parallel parking each other.
Yeah.
What if we did our dicks and then... But, like, mine, I put a beard on it.
Davey put a mustache. Oh, I have a mustache.
We could do the Bone Zone poster, but with our dicks. Yes.
The Bone Zone boners.
That would be a good poster.
We shouldn't have boners, though. That might be obscene.
Oh,
and it'd be hard for all 3 of us to keep boners with a photographer there and each other.
I think something
if
that
we make a rule, like, don't look at each other's boners while we're doing it, we can look at the picture.
Yeah. I just have a thing that every time I unzip my pants, I get a boner. Because it knows
the
that it's
air,
a, it's
the oxygen hitting his dick.
No, it's just like like Pavlov's dog where it hears something and something happens. Every time I unzip my pants, it's because I'm about to masturbate.
You've got
and
Pavlov's
so I just instantly
knob.
Get a boner. Well, not every time. Sometimes I'm just peeing and sometimes I'm changing my clothes. But
what
that's a very small amount compared to the amount I masturbate.
What if you hear somebody unzip? What if you just hear a fly unzip?
Mm-hmm.
Do you chub up?
A little bit, but it's also, you know, it's the action. It's my mindset knows I'm about to undo
the
my
muscle
pants.
Memory of it.
That's what, like, you know, crack addicts, they're not addicted to crack. They're addicted to the pipe. They're addicted to crack, too.
Yeah.
But there's something about seeing this paraphernalia and the location that you are that triggers you.
Gets those teeth a rattling.
So just getting my pants off is a boner trigger.
Speaking of addictions, do you guys want to teach me how to smoke a cigarette tonight?
I'd say masturbating is an addiction. An addict.
I guess it can be addictive.
An addict.
Yeah.
What do you mean? It's addiction. Addictive.
Addiction. And masturbating. All with.
Right. I don't get it. Yeah. Has, you said addictive.
Has the word dick in it.
Yeah.
Well, it's spelled D-I-C-C.
Addiction.
There are two C's?
D-I-C-T.
Masturbating. Let me take it
from
the top.
There's two D's. Addiction.
Masturbating is an addiction.
You should probably not pause in the middle of it. That makes
yeah,
because
then
seem
people
longer.
Won't know what you're talking.
You're
about.
Talking about it.
Masturbating is my
addiction. You're addicted to masturbating.
Addiction?
You need help?
Are you talking about like diction? Like
do we
like,
need an intervention?
Like your work? Yeah.
Okay. My masturbating
I'll give you a boner intervention.
Lowercase yeah. A.
Randy!
What are you doing?
Boner stop
intervention.
Boner!
This isn't helping.
Randy!
Shaming your boner.
Randy's boner.
This isn't.
Stop being a boner.
This isn't healthy.
Nobody likes when you come out. Nobody likes
nobody
it.
You're
causing people pain. Don't you realize this?
Usually when I have sex, this is like the type of activity that's happening.
Two guys yelled at. I'm one of the most people who've ever yelled at your boner at once.
Yeah.
Oh, twice
oh,
as
yeah.
many as that.
How many? Twice as many as that?
People on Twitter are saying, crotch shots and Nickelback. Why are you doing this to us?
Tell them that they don't.
It's free content.
It's not
do you go to
obligation.
Do you go to a restaurant and order something you're allergic to?
Yeah.
No. Come on. If you don't want to listen, don't listen.
I don't know if that's the best analogy.
No. Well, do you go to an you're like, I hate avocados. And then you go to a restaurant and you're like, extra avocados.
Go to avocado city.
And then you're like, I hate these avocados. I can't eat this. I hate them. If you hate us. No, you don't hate us. Come on.
You can't hate us. You're very addicted to us. Get it, Brendan?
Oh, yeah.
Like
the bone zone's like an addiction.
Yeah, like an addiction.
I was trying to say.
Yeah, with dick in the middle of the word.
No, it's no, get it, Randy? Because it's like the bone zone is an addiction.
Yeah, like a wiener in the middle of it.
Like a drug.
We're talking about D-I-C-K.
I mean, it's like a drug. Like you get addicted to our podcast.
Yeah.
Write that shit down. That's a bumper sticker.
Maybe it's because you keep showing
I'm
yours.
I'm addicted to the bone zone.
Mm-hmm. I'm a dick Ted. A guy named Ted. Dick, D-I-C-K-T-E-D. Dick.
Oh, so my name's Ted and I'm addicted to the bone zone.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Dick.
I'm
Ted and I'm a dick Ted to the bone zone.
Oh, like Dick and Ted's Excellent Adventure.
Dick and Ted's
like
Excellent
Dick
Bone Zone.
Dick and Ted are seeking, like they're going to Alcoholics Anonymous, but for the bone zone, and that's why they say, hi, I'm Dick and I'm Ted. I'm addicted to the bone zone.
So, I guess you kind of lost me on the Ted part, but
yeah.
I'm addicted to the bone zone is a cool slogan, I think.
Yeah, that is a good slogan.
Figure out how do you spell addicted? A-D-D-I-C-T-E-D. I'm addicted to the bone zone.
Yep.
You just want to make sure you spell everything right if you're going to put it on a bumper sticker.
Yeah, you know
but it should say D-I-C-K.
No, they'd be spelling it wrong.
Then you'd be saying a dick bone. That doesn't make sense.
Yeah, it doesn't. There's
we're trying to get across that our podcast is so popular that people get physically addicted
yeah,
to it.
Yeah, even when
that's
we're just
like,
showing cross
just calling people dicks or whatever.
Yeah.
Do you guys want to sit down in chairs? I've been standing all day.
I was just kidding. We do have chairs here, guys.
What?
I was just kidding. We do have chairs here.
You have
well,
fucking
I saw the
chairs
but you said that they were for Joe Rogan.
No.
Joe Rogan.
I don't want to cross Joe, man. That guy could probably...
He could take us out.
He could probably beat me up.
Probably.
Nah.
I'm taller than him.
Dude, you could take
so him. I'll have reach.
After the last podcast I did with Joe, he actually did physically attack me.
Did he?
Mm-hmm.
Why?
From behind?
No, he I made a joke and he laughed at it during the podcast, but then afterwards he's like, that shit wasn't funny, bro. And he put me in a sleeper hold.
Oh, man. What happened? Really? Did you fall asleep?
Well, I tried to put one of my moves on it.
But that's uh-oh.
He just has dance moves.
I tried to do a Michael Jackson spin, but because he had me by the neck, I didn't spin at all.
He injured
broke
yourself
his neck.
Further.
He got whiplash.
I snapped my own neck. and then he's actually in prison for snapping my neck.
Joe Rogan?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Whoa. I know that. That's why we don't have a show Wednesday.
Yep.
Well, that's tough to hear.
Heard it here first.
Yeah, heard it here first. Randy Lickie beat up Joe Rogan last week. crazy.
What if I... Do people challenge Joe to fights?
Do they?
Yeah, I mean, yeah. A lot of the martial arts guys always go like, "Hey, when are you going to roll with me, man?" Blah, blah, blah. Really?
But like they just want to like spar friendly.
Yeah, kind of. But you also have like the MMA freaks that just want to fight Rogan.
You know, you mean like fans? Like MMA fan freaks or MMA actual MMA like players?
A lot of UFC people. No, fans.
Fans?
Because like people try to, like, remember like Danny Bonaducci, people would always challenge him to fights and stuff.
Yeah.
Because they're like, "Oh, fuck that guy. I want to fight him. He's strong. He thinks he's strong." And like, Rogan is strong, so people probably try to show that they're fighty.
They probably didn't like Bonaducci's personality at the time too, because he's kind of like
yeah,
a hottie.
Bonaducci, yeah. But I can see people. Joe is like super like alpha strong guy.
Mm-hmm.
So if someone beats up Joe, and then they can like act like they're the strongest guy.
He's like Billy the Kid. He's the Billy the Kid of podcast.
What I'm trying to say is, should I challenge Joe to a fight?
I think you should call him out right now. On the podcast.
Should we call him up? Can you call up Joe and have Randy?
No, I'll just do I'll do a public announcement.
Okay.
Joe Rogan
probably won't get back to him.
Yeah, I'm sure he's not going to hear about it.
So. He sits in these chairs like tomorrow.
I'm going to challenge Joe Rogan to a bro pack.
Ooh.
I challenge him.
I didn't even get a chance to try to schedule a fight.
All right, hey everybody, listen up.
Listen up. You heard it here first.
Hey,
only
boneheads.
In America.
Only in America, in the good old U.S. of A., Randy Lidke wants to make an announcement. Ladies and gentlemen, Randy Lidke.
He may be red, but he ain't dead. Randy Lidke.
Hello, America. This is your golden child, Randy Lidke. I'm here to announce something very important. Joe Rogan, I think that I am stronger than you.
Ooh, yeah.
And I think that if you would be so kind, please accept this challenge to an all-out, no bars, no arm bars.
You're not allowed to use certain moves in this fight?
You can't do it in a bar, is what you're saying.
No
fighting
what
in
is
the
this,
bar.
What is the slogan? No holds barred. Okay, so no holds and no arm bars.
That means that he can do as many holds as possible because none of them are barred. Do you want to bar some holds?
No, isn't an arm bar a hold?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so none of those type of holds.
Okay.
But everything else is open.
Like kicking and punching?
No eye gouging or fish hooking.
Nothing in the face?
Nothing in the face. Okay. Good rule.
Okay.
Thank you. I challenge you to a fight. Joe Rogan, this is
you guys
Randy
heard
Lickie.
It here. This is getting this is very crazy, intense. Man.
If we could get a rebuttal.
You don't need this kind of infighting. But Randy obviously has an issue.
Are there any other... I don't have an issue with him.
You just want to fight him.
I just would like to fight him.
You want to prove your mettle?
What if he kills me?
Well...
Think about that.
You got a bunch of jokes in your book that I'll carry on in your honor.
You could maybe, if he kills you... I mean, before you do this fight, maybe get some... Like life insurance and leave me and Davey money so we can hire someone to replace you.
In but then life, what if you start like insurance? What if you start teaching Joe Rogan, you're like, listen, Joe, he just took life insurance. Here's some secret moves
fix it.
And then you split it with Joe.
Here's Randy's weaknesses. Well, you got really good coffee. Really good cup of coffee. Randy's weak to that.
I have kind of an Achilles heel in fighting.
It's your Achilles heel?
It is my heel.
It's your Achilles tendon?
It's my legs. I have Achilles legs.
I have an Achilles body.
Who was that comedian, that guy from Portland who did the Tomorrow Show, and he had that joke about like not washing himself from the waist down?
Richard Bain.
He doesn't wash his legs
or something? He's like, I just want to know, am I lazy? Guys, do you wash your legs?
I thought that was funny.
I love that guy. He's hilarious.
It's pretty true also. I mean, like, how many times do you guys do it like a full body, like you're doing like the back
every time
of your
I
legs?
Shower, man.
Really?
I wash my legs
every morning at 9:30 a.m.
But I don't, what I don't wash are my fists. Joe Rogan.
Whoa, so
heads up.
You got some nasty.
Literally heads up, Joe Rogan.
Nasty fists coming your way.
I have some secret tricks of the trade, and it's my fists, and they'd be punching.
In high school, we called Randy Stink Fist.
Stink Fist.
The Stink Fist way.
Yeah.
But all jokes aside, I challenge Joe Rogan to a fight.
And there's a list of rules that you can see on your, we'll put them on your Facebook or something.
Yeah,
list of rules are, from now on, until between now and the fight, we're not allowed to speak to each other.
Okay.
Joe and I aren't allowed to speak to each other.
You're not allowed to have sex.
With each other? With
no, anybody. No, no, with anybody. Yeah.
Okay. No sex
That's
allowed.
What fighters do before a big fight.
That way there's a lot of built up tension.
Yeah. Yeah, and if you get punched in the stomach really hard, one of you is going to come on the other.
Yeah. I think also to keep it fair,
you should have like two more guys on your like helping you.
Yeah, you need two guys backing you up.
Okay, so I get to choose two guys.
You get to choose two.
Does Joe get to choose two guys?
No. He's
so we get to choose. We get to choose the guys for Joe.
No, or Joe does get to choose two guys, but they're also for my team, and they're really bad.
Yeah.
So then I have five, me, plus two guys I choose, plus two guys he chooses to maybe fight those other two guys, and then it's just Joe. So let's just cancel those
okay,
four.
Okay, let's just cancel the four guys.
Right, also, one advantage, just to keep it fair between me and Joe, because I know the one advantage I do have is my smile. I have a very nice smile.
Okay.
No smiling.
Oh, no smiling?
No smiling during the fight, because if I smile and then he's just like, let's call it off.
He's charmed.
And then I attack.
Yeah. That's fighting dirty.
That's he's fighting charmed. Dirty, so I will not smile. That goes for you too, Joe. No smiling.
So it's... Well, you heard it here first. Okay, we got to throw a date in there and we'll charge. Yeah. We'll do it for charity.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so I'll do one more official announcement. Now that we have all the rules, I'll do one official announcement. That way someone could take that clip and just put that clip online.
Well, we could redo it. So whoever can isolate this clip, labeled as Randy Lidke challenges Joe Rogan to a fight.
Yeah.
Okay. To a some holds barred fight.
Some holds barred. Was it? How's this saying go?
Some holds barred
yeah. fight.
Some holds barred fight. And okay.
You okay, need to so be introduced we'll again. Start it. Put Randy on the camera.
Yeah, yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have an official Bone Zone announcement. Randy Lidke, what do you have to say?
Hey, what's up, everybody? This is Randy Lidke here to make an important announcement. I, on this day, in whatever month this is, challenge Joe Rogan to a some holds barred fight. And that includes any type of holds and any type of arm bars. No hitting in the face.
No smiling.
No smiling, and that's for him, because if I smile, he'll be like, good smile, and then I'll catch him off guard. So I won't smile. That's just to be polite to him. Also, he gets to choose two guys to fight on my team, and I get to choose two guys to fight on my team. So it'd be 5 versus 1. Chances are the guys he chooses will probably just be bad at fighting, and mine will be good. Let's just say
I thought we canceled the four extra guys.
So we're canceling the four extra guys. Me versus Joe Rogan in a fight. I challenge you, Joe.
Red Band, do you have Joe's schedule up on your computer there?
Yeah.
Let's figure out a date.
All right. This Friday.
4th of July. We'll this do a 4th Friday? Of July fight.
4th of July. That's
4th of July. July. July 4th.
Joe Rogan, America will be there to see this.
Yeah.
Some bars hold. What is it? Hold bars?
Some holds bars.
It'll be a patriotic pounding.
Some holds barred. So that means no holds and no arm bars. And also, between now and then, no sex. Build the tension.
Yeah.
Let's have a fight for America.
And you guys aren't allowed to hang out or talk to each other before.
No talking allowed, and all proceeds go to charity.
Yeah.
All right, Joe.
Well, okay. I can't say that I fully condone this kind of infighting, but the challenge has been made.
Randy's got fire in his eyes. Randy's got the fire in his eyes. Check that out.
I don't know if I'd want to do this if I were Joe Rogan.
He's got the flame of the redhead.
I don't want to step to that. Who in their right mind would step to that?
I don't know. He's gone crazy. Ladies and gentlemen, Randy has taken off his earphones.
This is not going to... Oh, see, now he's smiling.
Oh, he smiled. He charmed himself.
I'm all...
He's back.
Oh, shit.
He's crazier than ever. Here, Randy, do you need someone to look intense for you?
Yeah.
Okay. Hold on.
Hold on, I can't do it.
Look, go to Brendan real quick.
All right, one real good look from all three of us. No, wait, no wait, smiling wait. At all.
Okay.
All right. Well, start on someone else. You can't show me preparing. Do I look into that one? Okay. Well, but show someone else first, because.
Okay. All right, be serious, y'all. Just really focus. This is hard.
It is.
Just think about the fight, man. It's going to be a good fight. We suck, man. We can't even not smile.
We're trying to be actors and shit. Can't even fucking do that.
What if I...
For the people listening on iTunes, we should explain we just tried to stare down a camera.
We just basically tried to not smile. We're fucking losers. We're
going to do it.
That's going to be really hard while I'm fighting.
Wait, maybe if all three of us, like two of us stand behind Randy, and then we can do more intense, because it's the anticipation of it coming over to us. Maybe it's making us smile.
Yeah.
Should we do like a group... Like a group intensity?
All three of us?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Which, just go over to Randy?
Yeah.
So we pop up from behind Randy?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay. So Randy, you start.
You start the look. You're already looking, and then we come up behind you on either side with our own intense look.
All right, and I'll show my dukes.
Okay, ready?
Audio listeners, I'm about to show my most serious face I've ever had. I'll give you a cue. Zoom out a little bit, bro.
If you're an audio listener, don't stop listening.
Yeah. Did we get a good enough sound file for my challenge to Joe? I feel like I messed it up. Should I do another one?
Do another one.
Here's a quick one for like the in-between commercials.
Oh, for like
the 15-second
to promote
commercial.
It or whatever.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. Here's the quick one. Hey, what's up? This is Randy Libke. Joe Rogan, I'm calling you out. I'm gonna fight you. Some holds barred. No holds and no arm bars, no smiling. 4th of July, you and me fight for America. I refuse to smile. Don't fuck with my voice. All right, we have to start over.
All right.
Don't mess with my voice. I'm trying to be serious. Hey, what's up? This is Randy Libke. Joe Rogan, I challenge you to a fight on 4th of July. Some holds barred. That means no. All right, I'm starting over. Hey, what's up? This is Randy Libke. Joe Rogan, I'm calling you out to a fight on 4th of July. Me and you. Some bars, some holds. All right, I'm starting over. Hey, what's... Fuck! Hey, what's up? This is Randy Libke. Joe Rogan, I'm calling you out. We're going to fight each other. I challenge you to a fight on the 4th of July. There's a few rules. I won't smile because... I'll use that to my benefit. All right, I'm starting over. Hey, what's up? This is... Well, I think they get the picture.
Yeah. Here, do me again.
A lot of intense stares. Yeah.
Okay, is it on me?
Yeah. I want a spinny.
Okay.
I want to do one, too.
So for those of you just listening at home, we're now spinning around in our chairs to reveal our serious, angry looks.
Let me know when you're ready.
Go to left. Go to the left.
Sorry.
Go back to the first camera?
Yeah.
Oh.
This is so stupid.
All right.
I mean, we're tough guys is basically our point. Oh, that's good.
Yeah.
All right, let's do that one more time. We ditched the microphones all together.
Perfect for audio.
Wait, I don't want to fight Joe Rogan.
Well, you're gonna have to explain it to like 10 times you called him out on a podcast.
I didn't. Did
Fourth of July.
Can't prove it.
I thought you said Fred Rogan the whole time.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Well,
I thought it meant Seth Rogan. I said I got the names all wrong.
Oh. Oh, no.
Now
hey, what's
start
up?
Over.
Okay. What's up, y'all? This is Randy Lidke. Hey, Seth Rogan, star of Pineapple Express. I challenge you to a fight. I'm a punch you like crazy, and you're gonna have to deal with it because I'm a better fighter than you. And guess what? There are a few rules. Rule number one: just be yourself. Rule number two: no cheating. All right, Seth Rogen, it's a fight, and it's on.
Here, do me again.
Shit.
So that was the visual portion.
You know how like when fighters, like before their fight, there's a publicity part where they square up and they do face to face?
Yeah.
Can you imagine
just how like, much they giggle?
Just one guy cracking up, just fucking, just being like, "Come on, look how silly we're being."
Yeah, but they're trying to like that. They're like trying to hold it together, and one person just goes like out of his nose, just laughs a little, and they just break the fuck up.
Or
like
one of them
in
farts.
Church. Yeah. Well, to counteract that whole visual portion, which was pretty great. So if you only have audio of this, try to find some video and see the faces we're making.
Go to Ustream. Yeah.
Lots of good faces. Podcast faces. But to balance that out, I know a lot of people, your favorite part of the podcast is the noises we make. And I want to premiere a new noise that we have for this week. So if you guys want to join me, I'll start it off. You'll get the idea. Right. I call it the little kid doing an old-timey fire engine bell. Okay. Here goes. Okay. So there you go. That'll make up for all the silence that you heard.
Oh, it was extra noise.
That was extra noise.
More noises.
Yeah, it was just extra. It was a new noise that we premiered.
The mean of noise to silence will average out.
Exactly.
Yeah.
We gave you guys...
The average will average.
Just a new noise. I mean, David, you have a noise you would like to make in a microphone? And then we could always join in.
Oh, yeah. What was I... I was saying... I was doing that one noise. What did I call it?
It was like lap dog inside a bag.
Yeah, the lap dog inside the bag. Are you ready?
Oh. pretty good. That was more like, that was a little more psychedelic for everyone. For all you like, druggies out there.
Yeah.
It's kind of like a David Lynch film.
Have you guys, I don't know if you want to try this. We go round, do the three of us.
Okay.
Because it's complicated. This might be a little complicated. But you know that song where the dogs bark jingle bells?
Oh, yeah.
Well, we could try to do that and just do go one at a time.
We forgot to announce up top, this is technically our...
Oh, it's our Christmas party.
Our Bone Zone corporate Christmas party.
Well, because we know, yeah, the month of December is packed.
Impossible.
It's so expensive to get it. Yeah, it's expensive and like... It's
and everybody else has Christmas parties to go to, so we thought, well,
including
have ours.
Including us, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Nobody came to our Christmas party, but I guess we didn't really advertise it well. We could do it again next week.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's our Christmas party. So should we? Do you want to try to bark jingle bells?
The yeah, let's do it. Merry Christmas, guys.
So
Merry Christmas.
Like we'll just go around each bark. Oh, you want me to start?
So
start?
One bark at a time.
Bark, one bark at a tark. Okay. At a time. One bark at a tark.
Okay. One bark.
That's
at a
another
bark?
T-shirt idea. One bark at a tark. Yeah. All right.
And I knocked the sperms out of my cum.
Okay.
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 People are watching this. 80.
300.
Oh, 300 of you just got pwned. You just got pwned.
You just got pwned.
I was trying to bring this up earlier, but there...
Hey, what's up, y'all? This is Randy Lidke. Joe Rogan, I'm calling you out. I'm going to fight you
Randy,
with my fists.
Seth Rogan. It's Seth Rogan.
Oh, shit. Okay, never mind.
There's my neighbor kid asked me if I could teach him how to smoke, and I was like, I don't know how to smoke, and he gave me this look like I'm not an adult. So I was wondering if you guys could teach me how to smoke here tonight.
A cigarette?
A cigarette, yeah.
Oh.
Like this kid just gave me like I said.
Do you want to learn too?
Yeah.
He said, "Do you want to?" He's like, "Could you teach me how to smoke?"
How much to buy a cigarette from you?
$18. I sell them for.
All right.
Okay, so
I'm good for it.
I'll do you guys want to just share a smoke? Or
yeah,
you both
we'll
smoke?
Share one.
You want to share one?
Yeah.
Okay. So let me watch you light it up first.
Ooh, I want to be the guy who lights it.
You want me to light it? Oh, no, yeah, let Randy light it.
Oh, guys, this will be romantic.
All up to you.
So if you're
for myself. I want to light it for myself.
Oh, Randy's lighting it? Okay.
Oh, but Davey, you guys both want to learn how to smoke.
Yeah.
All right.
Well, here goes Randy. He's
I'll
lighting
it
up.
I'll pass it right away.
Okay. He's putting it.
All right, here we go.
He's holding it not from the filter. I think you hold it from the filter.
Oh, okay. All right, it's the right way. Okay.
So for those of you at home who aren't watching, Randy and Davey are learning how to smoke.
Oh, he just puffed on it.
He's getting it lit.
He's got it real lit.
It's probably lit.
Oh, whoa, how's it taste?
It smells good. Okay. It's real good.
How do I do this now? I got it.
You got it lit.
Okay.
Now just...
Is that the proper way to hold it?
Yeah, it looks natural.
Stiffly between your fingers, shaking.
Yeah, it does look natural.
Shaking all nervously.
All right, smoke it, dog.
It's natural, yeah. And you just put it in your mouth. Yeah, just put it in your mouth.
Have it cherry.
Not all the way. Don't put it all the way in your mouth. I mean, no.
No, too deep.
Just put the brown part in your mouth.
Especially if you're sharing.
Okay. Yeah. There you go. Just put the brown, like half the brown part in. There you go. And just suck on it like a straw.
Damn, you're...
And inhale, like, then just breathe in, like, the way you breathe. Is it in there?
I don't know.
Did you get it?
Let it out.
I don't know. Oh, nothing went in.
Let me try.
Here, I'll
you
try
suck
again.
It like a straw. There you go. Okay, now. Yeah, Davey just smoked.
Oh, God.
He's totally... you are totally midget-lipping.
Midget-lipping? What's that mean?
Smells bad.
Are you sucking it in?
I don't know. It smells bad.
Oh, Randy's learning.
We gotta send a video of this to Randy's mom. Is Randy smoking?
Wait, did you?
Oh, dude, he's addicted to it now.
Get a close up, dog.
Whoa, flicked it into a tray like a master.
He's gonna challenge someone to a fight, I think.
Oh, God.
Oh, fuck. Now that he smokes, he thinks he's even tougher.
Here, let me challenge. I'll challenge Joe Rogan to a bro pack with a cigarette in my mouth.
Hey, what's up, dog? It's Randy Lickey, smoking a cigarette. Joe Rogan, I challenge you to fight on the 4th of July.
The Seth wrote, well.
I want to fight Joe again.
Okay. Yeah, all right.
You think Joe would kill me?
Smoking Davey. No, I think it'd be a pretty even fight.
Here, I'll act like an old-time radio guy who okay. used to smoke. This next number goes out to all the women out there listening to us here live on the Bone Zone podcast.
You're very sporadic with the.
Have you ever had to smoke for a role or anything?
No, I'm trying to learn just in case I do need to smoke for a roll. But you'd have probably the herbal non.
Yeah, a roll? Like a piece of bread?
Like a dinner roll, yeah.
Randy! I'm sorry! So, Edward R. Murrow.
So, Davey, are you hooked?
Yeah, you Edward R. Murrow. You're not interviewing a celebrity. Brendan Walsh.
Yeah.
You bring laughter to the world.
Mm-hmm.
Comedy to the masses.
Yep, all across the globe, everyone loves me. That's pretty good. Don't spray that on his.
No, that's dangerous. Flammable dog.
Flammable dogs. Why flammable dogs.
Is that a thing?
That's our band.
Dogs are probably flammable.
It'll explode. No exploding. Oh shit! Davey exploded.
Brendan.
Mm-hmm.
What's the saddest dream you've ever had?
One time I had a dream that I was flying, and then I saw my mommy kissing Santa Claus.
From over up top?
Yeah, it was like more of an out-of-body experience. I was dressed as Santa Claus. My mom thought I was my dad, and she started making out with me, so I passed out.
One time I saw my mother burying Santa Claus.
When's the last time you saw your mom nude?
Ooh, that's a good one. Not since I was a child, probably. Not since I was really, really, really young.
It's been like 2 weeks since I've seen your mom nude.
Really? Mm-hmm. How's she looking? How's she looking these days?
It's okay. She's got her own website.
My parents take night baths before they go to bed. Bed baths. And so sometimes...
And beyond?
Bed baths and beyond.
Sometimes they go beyond, yeah.
And so when I'm home for the holidays or something, if I'm out watching a movie in the living room, she'll go in because there's like a hallway. There's a living room, and then there's a hallway that has, in the middle of the hallway, right when you walk into it, there's a door into the bathroom, and then on either side of that hallway is like, there's a den, and then there's my parents' room. So you see them coming out of the bathroom into the room after they take their bed bath. My dad's always like in his sweatpants and his t-shirt that he wears to bed. Mm-hmm. And my mom will come out sometimes in her nightgown, and occasionally it's unnecessarily sheer. And so I guess if that counts as seeing my mom nude, then probably December.
Oh, boy. Yeah, nobody wants to see that. I'm not talking about your mom specifically. Nobody wants to see their mom.
Do you guys have proper pajamas?
I have some pajama pants.
You know what I was thinking? There was one day that I was like, I tweeted about it. I was like, I haven't taken. Okay. Like,
ooh, looking cool. Looking cool, Randy.
God damn it.
Yeah. I smoked one time in Canada.
Was it to look cool?
Yeah, because they have shitty cigarettes there. So I brought some American ones to make friends. And then I lied and said I was in the NFL and they didn't care. I think classic Randy College. I was like, I play for the Arizona Cardinals. And they were like, I don't care. And I was like, just kidding, I play for the NHL. And they go, no, you don't.
Oh.
And I was like, got me.
Yeah.
The National Horny League.
Oh, I was like, I really wanted to get some
Davey's
proper.
Got a whole new cool attitude, actually.
I wanted to get some proper pajamas. I almost called you, Davey, to be like, let's go get matching PJs.
We should get matching PJs.
I want to go to Target and just get like cheap matching PJs.
Let's do a pajama party.
Can we have
a
slumber party?
All three of us. Yeah. Here? Matching PJs.
But then can we have a slumber party and stay at one of our houses? Well, not at my place is way too small.
We'd stay at my place.
Okay.
Oh man.
Let's go. So next,
we'll prank call girls.
We'll announce it right here. I'll announce it.
Next week.
Do you want the cigarette?
Yeah, I'll announce it.
Randy's got an announcement. Everybody listen up! Randman's making an announcement. Shut up!
Yo, what's up, dog? This is Randy Lidke. Next week on the Bone Zone will be a pajama party. All three of us will have matching pajamas. Also, Joe Rogan, I want to fight you on the 4th of July.
No.
No, you're not. Fight's not part also, of the pajama party. Also, so, Joe, if you're listening, don't come to our pajama party and beat us up.
Also, this is
what if Joe shows up and just pummels all
in
three
the, in
of
matching
us.
Pajamas.
Yeah. Here's the thing about when we go back to have the sleepover at your house. Mm-hmm. Let's try to get people to send in phone numbers. If they're girls, send in your phone numbers, or if you know of girls' phone numbers, send them in, and we'll be making phone calls to girls.
Oh,
all
I have
long.
An extra cell phone.
Oh, and we'll call. Yeah, we'll call and be it. Like, so send us your numbers, and then we'll call and tell you which one of us has a crush on you.
Yeah.
And then we can even continue the podcast at my place. We can get the your lap the way you guys do the door knocker.
The Ustream. We'll Ustream
our pajama party.
Oh, shit.
And we can leave it on all night while we sleep.
Oh, yeah.
And old men can
old
watch
men are
sleep.
Gonna watch us sleep.
Yeah. Don't rub one out if you're watching us, though.
Well, oh, shit. You might see us get sleep.
Well,
boners.
If you're a girl, I guess you can.
Yeah. What if you'll just see one of us, like, every 30 minutes, one of us is going to be masturbating, thinking the other two are asleep.
Oh, God. That's going to be hard. Maybe we should sleep in shifts.
Oh, yeah. So one person sleeps or two people sleep?
Let's, two people sleep. Let's sleep one guy caps. Masturbates. When you're done masturbating, you wake up another guy and you go to sleep. This is how we do it. Now the party's getting started.
Yeah.
Yeah. La da 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 da. Oh, sorry. I don't need to do it.
Do we tell you about the segment we want to do called This Is How He Drew It? This is how he drew it.
And then it's just us,
it's
being
us
like
dancing, and then we cut to Pendleton Ward drawing from like a medium shot, and you don't even, and then he holds up whatever he drew, and then we cut back to us dancing.
It has a title this card, so it's like Apple.
Okay.
This is how he drew it.
Wait, we could draw pictures too. You know?
Yeah, we don't need
we don't need your fancy animator friend to draw all the pictures.
Yeah, let's just do it. This is how we do it. It's Friday night. Oh man.
What's that song about? Sex?
Didn't we go through that whole song
last
week?
Yeah, we did go through that whole song last
that
week.
That song we did?
Yeah. That's all about he gives his keys to the designated driver.
Yeah.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Designated driver, take the keys
to my truck.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that part.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's also the song that Howie Mandel's show, This Is How We Do It.
Yeah.
This Is How We Do It.
This Is How We Do It.
Randy knows how we do it.
If you watch the show, it's clear how he does it. It's wigs. He just wears wigs.
And glasses.
And
fake
glasses.
Yeah. He tricks people. Really big glasses.
And he was all like, this is how
we do it. We should try to corner the Howie Mandel pranks genre.
Well, they have that Betty White show now. Mm-hmm. I don't know if it's still on.
What if we do it with
has,
little kids?
It has, like, some potential, but it's, like, packaged so cheesy together.
No, I haven't seen it.
Like, the idea of old people pulling pranks is funny.
It is funny. I've seen...
There's a few that are funny.
I've seen a bit, but I don't...
It's just, like, it's thrown together so
isn't it mostly
so
old people
cheesy.
Dying or something? They're
no.
Like, oh.
They end on not, like, strong moments. Like,
it's just like an old lady pulls up in a wheelchair and starts rapping.
Yeah, and then they play, like, a weird, like, song. They're like, check it out, this is an old lady. And this is a funny part. And then it's, like, two, three, four...
Yeah.
And then it cuts to the next scene, and it's like, it didn't end
they should
on
have
a like
segment.
A punch.
They should have a segment that they get, they just show, like, closed-circuit TV video of Hugh Hefner fooling women into his bedroom.
There's one that was really funny where it's like this old, it's an old man, he shows up at a skate park, and he opens his old man bag and pulls out a skateboard.
His balls?
Oh, I don't know if it was in a commercial or if it was on...
Old man bag is euphemism for balls, right?
Yeah, he pulls a skateboard out of his balls, and then he does all these amazing, like street tricks.
Yeah.
And then these guys watch it happen, and it's pretty cool. But it doesn't... they do a lot of... Remember that show Trigger Happy TV?
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought that was funny, that show.
Ron
Lynch was a consultant on that.
Yeah.
Oh, man. I brought that up at so many meetings because I was like...
That type
I have
stuff.
Meetings about prank shows a lot.
Yeah.
And... I don't want to just do a prank show where you just fuck with, like, I don't know. I don't want to be, like, dressed as a UPS guy.
Social pranks are the best.
Yeah, like social experiment or just weird things. Like, I remember Trigger Happy TV used a lot of, like, weird, like, bunny suits and stuff.
We did a kind of a Trigger Happy TV similar thing, now that I think about it, on one of the Breaking the Laws with the Door Knockers. We did a street performance.
Oh, yeah.
And we just held a single note as long as we could until someone left.
These 15 teenagers, like, stood there for
they
about 30 seconds.
They just sat there and watched
then,
us play our instruments. But it was one long note until they walked away.
As soon as they were across the street,
and they laughed.
Kind of out of
they
earshot,
kind of got
stopped.
It, and then they like they acted like they wanted to leave, but then they stuck it out, and then they finally
and then
realized.
They really wanted to leave.
It was like a minute and a half of just holding a note.
That's good.
And then they walked away.
Yeah.
You don't have video, though? Just audio?
Just audio.
Just audio.
That's good. And is that released? Have you released
Yeah, Breaking the Law with the Door Knockers on iTunes. We just put two new episodes.
So what are you up to, 11? 12?
Oh, I'm not 10? Sure how many we have. Our most recent ones were running a stop sign and spitting on sidewalks.
How many total Breaking the Laws? How many laws have you guys broken so far?
How many episodes?
Yeah.
Let me look.
Randy's going to look it up.
I'll pull it up.
I have to get going real quick. Should
Davey's got to go buy a pack of smokes.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, he's addicted fully.
I got to go get my fix, man.
Well, that was enough Bone Zone, I think.
I had a great time. It's great seeing you three.
It's good to see you guys.
I just really have a great time when you guys are around, Red Man. Yeah. Same goes for you, bro. I just really have a great time here.
Good to see you. Thanks for welcoming us into your home every week.
Yeah. Opening the doors to us.
Thanks for opening the doors for us, Red Band. Red Band!
Starting all the machines.
Red Band!
What? Let's hear it for...
Red Band!
Come on, guys.
Thanks!
Just accept it.
Thanks, idiot!
We like you, Red Band!
One last thing. Yo, what's up? This is Randy Libke.
Oh, wait. Joe Rogan. Everybody shut up. Oh, Randy's got an announcement.
Here it comes.
Yo, what's up? This is Randy Libke. Joe Rogan, I challenge you to fight on the 4th of July. Me and you, just each other fighting each other. There are some... holds barred, and that includes all holds and all bars. Got that? Also, I won't smile because I'll use that as an advantage. And also, no sex between now and then.
So today's June 12th, 2012. So nobody's having sex. And actually, if you plan on coming to the Staples Center to see this fight,
nobody.
Don't have sex.
Anybody listening?
Everybody has to prove that they didn't have sex somehow.
It's not actually at a Staples Center. It's at a Staples.
Well, it's at the Staples center of a Staples Vine. In Burbank. We're going to go and...
It's at the very middle of the Staples near my house.
Exactly. Yeah. We'll just go to the Staples. You guys will go find... We'll find the center of the Staples.
Yep, Staples Center.
And then you guys will fight for how many rounds? Three, I guess? Is that what they usually do?
Three rounds. However many girls we can get to come with numbers to hold up, that's how many rounds we'll have.
Oh, that's good. Yeah, so
might be
might have to
rounds.
Do like a 15 rounder.
Yep, 15 rounder. You guys heard it here first. That's July 4th. Anything coming up between now and then?
I will be I, Brendan Walsh, July 19th through the 21st, I'll be in Madison, Wisconsin. I'll be in Madison, Wisconsin, something on State. What's it called? Comedy on State? I don't fucking know. And I'll be at the Montreal Comedy Festival. Then August, I'll be in Portland. And then I'm recording a CD. Mark it on your calendars if you live in San Francisco. I'm going to record a CD at the Purple Onion. I don't know, maybe on September 6th.
It's a great fucking club, man.
And I'll be performing all around town until then.
Every Saturday, Randy and I will be at the Tomorrow Show.
Every
Steve Allen Theater.
Every Saturday at the Steve Allen Theater in Hollywood. It's on Hollywood Boulevard.
Every Monday and Friday, if you guys have an internet connection and a computer, go to What's What. YouTube.com/whatswhat and see a new What's What.
Yeah, I'm doing a few shows in LA in July.
Randy's got some stand-up gigs.
July 1st at Tex?
Tex. T-A-I-X.
On Sunset, called French Toast. It's a French restaurant. And also I'm doing Meltdown at Meltdown Comics in Hollywood on 18th of July.
I'll be at the Brea Improv one of these nights.
I'm going to be getting drinks at the Public House on Monday.
Also, I'll be working my job 40 hours a week, serving
let's
coffee.
See.
Also, one last thing. Yo, what's up, Doc? This is Randy Libke. Joe Rogan, I challenge you to fight me versus you, 4th of July. Got it?
I'll be doing the Power Violence Show on June 24th.
Oh, is that the Bro Show?
The Bro Show.
Davey and I have just been added to that show.
We've just been added to the Bro Show.
You can see all three Bone Zone guys if you go to the Power Violence Show on Santa Monica Boulevard at 9 p.m. on June 24th. Then on the 25th, you can come see me at the Hot House Show. That is downtown somewhere. And then
Hot House Studios.
June 26th, You could see me do the Holy Fuck Show, which is also downtown.
Downtown Independent Theater.
And then on June 27th, I will be performing on the Meltdown Comics Show here in Hollywood, California.
It's a great show.
And then on the 28th, I'm attending a live show of Jurassic Park.
And if anybody out there wants to go on a sweet-ass date with the coolest dude in the world, I just got two tickets.
Yeah, that's right. Brendan Walsh is single. And look at Domingo.
Yeah, Brendan Walsh.
Yeah, I need dates. Give me dates. I want sex. Give me dates. Brendan, yeah. All single girls. Brendan, come.
If you guys are looking for a nice, quiet date, two tickets to Batman. I just got the Batman movie.
Anywhere, anytime.